Welcome back, guys. Today we'll be looking at Mapleson circuits. So Mapleson circuits are breathing circuits, okay, which are used in anesthesia or in other conditions as well to provide ventilation to a person. So what is a breathing circuit actually? So importantly, we have to look at the definition of a breathing circuit to understand it better. Now, in a breathing circuit, it's defined as an assembly of components, okay, assembly of components which connect patient's airway to a machine, okay, preferably an anesthetic machine, which is maintaining an artificial atmosphere. Okay, so when you dissect this, you see that there's a word component, then artificial atmosphere. So these are the two important things that you need to note down over here. So a breathing circuit has a specific set of components and it has an artificial atmosphere. That means we will be controlling the type of air which is going to enter the person's airway. That's the importance of maintaining an artificial atmosphere. Now, Mapleson circuits have a specific list of components. So if you would look at the anatomy of the machine or the circuits itself, you would see that there's a face mask, okay, which will be denoted by the triangle because it would look like a face mask. Then we have a reservoir bag. Reservoir bag will be like circle, a corrugated tube which would preferably connect the face mask to the reservoir bag, a fresh gas flow inlet and an outlet. So the outlet can be called APL, that's adjustable pressure limiting valve, or an expiratory valve preferably. Now the face mask will be at the patient end, the reservoir bag hopefully at the operator end, and the FGF outlet and the APL are variable. Okay, they can be at different locations, maybe even absent in some cases as we'll look. Now the reservoir bag has a few functions, so this you'll need to remember. Now, one, it acts as a reservoir for fresh gas during inspiration. So imagine if the reservoir bag is filled and the person is inspiring and the fresh gas flow is slower than what the person is inspiring from, the gas which has accumulated in the reservoir bag can be used for his inspiration. Second, it's used to accommodate fresh gas in expiration. So while expiring, the fresh gas is collected into the reservoir bag while the person expires, and the gas which is expired from the person either moves into the tube or through the outlet valve. And third, assist and monitor breathing. So by looking at the movement of the reservoir bag, you can see the state of the person's respiration. Is he suffering from bradypnea or tachypnea, or is it full, or to what extent is he capable of breathing? And by pressing it, you can actually assist the respiration. Okay, now the APL valve, a few things about this. It's one way, it just opens. Second, it's spring loaded, so the spring will determine the amount of pressure that the APL valve will exert. So when the expiration pressure is more than the spring pressure, then expiration will occur. When expiration pressure is greater than spring pressure, yeah. So next we look at the proper anatomy. So how to identify different types of circuits, yeah. So there are six. So we have A to F. Now A has all the components. So it has a fresh gas flow, it has a reservoir bag, it has a corrugated tube, it has a face mask, and it has an outlet near the patient end. So the things you have to note in this is the fresh gas flow is at the operator end, okay, and we have all the components which are present, all components. Now, when you look at B and C, we will be seeing that there is a reservoir bag in both, and then there is a mask, of course, and the fresh gas flow and the outlet are near the mask. Okay, but the only difference is B, there is a corrugated tube connecting the reservoir bag and the face mask, while we don't have any such provision in C. So C, actually, if you were to look at it properly, it would appear smaller. Okay, so it does not have that extendability, so it's a smaller version of B, C. Next, so you can remember like that. So C for corrugated tube, so corrugated tube is absent. Now D, we have a reservoir bag, we have the outlet, corrugated tube, the inlet, and the face mask. Okay, then when we look at the E, it's open. Okay, then we have a corrugated tube, we have a fresh gas flow inlet, and the face mask. And F, direct opening, a reservoir bag, we have corrugated tube, an inlet, and a mask. Now, when you look at E and F, you'll see that one, there is no APL. Yeah. Second, in E, there is no bag. And when you look at these three, and when you look at these three, one clear thing which you can see is here, the fresh gas flow is nearer to the patient. Okay. Near patient. While in these cases, the APL was nearer than the fresh gas, and in E and F, APL is absent. So this is how you identify it. A has all the components, okay, all the components with fresh gas at the operator end. B has all the components, but the fresh gas is towards the patient end. C is same B without a corrugated tube. E and F do not have an APL, okay, and E does not even have a bag. While D has FGF nearer and the APL, so it's basically a reversed version of A. Okay, when you look at FGF and APL, D is a reversed version of A. So we'll have to look at a few properties of them individually as well. In all the circuits from A to F, if the person is undergoing spontaneous ventilation, if he is able to breathe on his own, the APL is kept open. Okay, and if the person is not able to breathe on his own, if we are supplying him with controlled breathing, then the APL is half closed, half or partial, okay, or semi sufficiently. So these are the words which are used. So it's not necessarily half closed, it's sufficiently closed or partially closed, so it's not exactly half closed. Okay, so but which means that spontaneous breathing, you need APL to be open, and for control you need APL to be closed. So when we look at these two things, that's the F and E, you see that there is no APL. So spontaneous breathing cannot occur by E and F Mapleson type circuits. Okay, good. Now A, when we look at A, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you specific properties which you'll need to remember, specific points for A, B, C, D, E and F, and I'll explain how the breathing system works in A and B, and using that you should apply the way that fresh gas is continuously supplied to the person. So that breathing mechanism I'll be explaining in the ending of the video. It's a lot to take in, so I'll just give you the specific points which are really required for your entrance exams. And the mechanism I'll explain to you at the end, okay? Okay, so first A. A is also called the Magill modification or the Magill circuit. And the specialty is the FGF, fresh gas flow inlet, is at the operator end. Okay, that's one of the main things that you need to remember. B. As you see B, to prevent rebreathing, Okay, the main intention of Mapleson circuit says the person should be getting only that gas during inspiration that we have kept in our environment. So he is not even allowed to take back his own expirated air. Okay, so to prevent rebreathing, the fresh gas flow should be 20 to 25 liters per minute. Okay, so this implies A circuit is more efficient. Yeah, next, C is a modification of B, but no tube. We already saw that. Now D, E and F have T modifications. Okay, what's a T modification? When you look at the structure, initially there's a T. Okay, so this could be the inlet, this could be the outlet, and this could be the tube which is connecting the reservoir to the mask. So this is what we call a T modification. Yeah, it looks like a T. Now D has a modification called Bain modification, in which the corrugated tube is removed and instead there's an outer tube and there's an inner tube, and the inner tube is the input for fresh gas flow while the output is connected to the outer tube. Okay, so that, next we come to E. E is called arrest modification, and it's used in children up to 30 kilogram of body weight. And F is called Jackson-Rees modification. It's basically E with an additional reservoir bag. So since it has a reservoir bag, you can monitor and assist in breathing. Okay, you can monitor and assist in breathing, but F requires high gas flow compared to the others. Okay, so these are the specific points that you would need to know. So how does breathing work? So I'll draw A circuit here. So we have the fresh gas flow, we have a reservoir bag, we have a corrugated tube connecting it, we have the outlet, and we have the mask. Okay, so initially while the patient inspires, we have air coming in, the air comes in, goes in through the mask, and the patient breathes. Now when he expires the air, okay, so he inspired and it stopped, so we have fresh gas in this region. Now when he expires, the gas comes out, and it moves and it pushes the red, that's the fresh gas, backwards. And the red gas does not go back here, no, it gets accumulated in the reservoir bag. So it gets filled up here. So when it does get filled up, when the reservoir bag gets filled up, there's a pressure. So the pressure of the reservoir bag plus the pressure of expiration from this, so this is the P expiration and P reservoir bag, will be more than the APL pressure that we have set. So the APL valve opens and the gas escapes out. Okay, so in the next step, when the person breathes again, the fresh gas which is coming in and the gas from here by the contraction of the reservoir bag will push the remaining expired gas or the alveolar gas out, and then it will be inspired. Okay, that's how it works. So the main intention is there should be no rebreathing. So we want him to inspire only the gas that we have prepared in the artificial atmosphere. So to prevent rebreathing and to maintain ventilation, to maintain respiration of only the gas that we have preset, let it be anesthesia, let it be 100% oxygen, let it be humidified air. Okay, so that's the aim of the Mapleson circuit. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. And if you want any video made, please request it in the comment section below. Thank you guys for your support. Bye.